As we have completed exercise 7.2 yesterday, so today we are going to start exercise 7.3. So the first question is triangle ABC and triangle DBC are two isosceles triangles on the same base BC, and vertices A and D are on the same side of BC. And if AD is extended to intersect BC at P, then we have to show that these four parts we have to prove one by one. So let us see the figure first. In this one, it is given that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. It means AB equal to AC. And DBC is also an isosceles triangle. It means DB equal to DC. And when AD is extended, it meets at P on BC. So now in the first part, we have to prove that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. So we will take these two triangles first. In triangle ABD and triangle ACD, you can see here ABD and ACD. In these two triangles, this side is common, and AB equal to AC as it is given, because ABC is an isosceles triangle, so AB equal to AC. Similarly, BD equal to DC. These are also the sides of an isosceles triangle. So using SSS criteria, these two triangles are congruent. In the second part, we have to prove that triangle ABP congruent to triangle ACP. So now taking these triangles, in triangle ABP and triangle ACP, you can see that AP equal to AB, that is common. In triangle ABP and ACP, this side is common. Next one, angle PAB equal to angle CAP by CPCT, because in the first part we have proved that these two triangles are congruent, and therefore by CPCT these two angles will be equal to each other. And thirdly, AB equal to AC as this is an isosceles triangle. So by SAS rule, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. Now in the third part, we have to prove that AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. So here, as in the first part we have proved these two triangles congruent, and these are the CPCT. So PAB equal to PAC by part 1. So AP bisects angle A. It means if these two angles are equal, it means AD is a bisector of angle A. Now coming to these triangles, triangle BPD and CPD. In these two triangles, PD is common, BD is equal to DC, as these are the sides of an isosceles triangle. And BP equal to PC, these are equal because these are the corresponding parts of congruent triangles, as we have proved ABP equal to ACP. So BP equal to PC. So here we have written BP equal to CP, BD equal to CD, and PD equal to PD, that is common. So by SSS rule, BPD congruent to CPD. And if these are congruent, their corresponding part will also be equal. So this angle, that is BDP, equal to CDP. And if these two angles are equal, it means AP is bisecting angle D also. So AP bisects angle D also. Now coming to the last part. In this one, we have to prove that AP is perpendicular bisector of BC. So two things we have to prove here. One is bisector and one is perpendicular. The bisector part we have already proved, that is BP equal to CP. This was by CPCT. And next one, BPD equal to CPD by CPD. These are also by CPCT because these two triangles are, we have proved as congruent. So these two angles are corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So these are equal to each other and BP equal to PC is also equal. So angle BPD equal to CPD and these two angles are also forming the linear pair. So because these are forming linear pair, so sum of these two angles will be 180 degree. And because these are equal, so in the place of CPD we can put PPD, or in the place of BPD we can put CPD. So I have put BPD in the place of CPD. So BPD plus angle BPD equal to 180 degree. So this is twice of PPD equal to 180 degree. It means BPD equal to 180 upon 2, that is 90 degree. So this angle is 90 degree. It means AP is perpendicular bisector of BC.